After 35 years of war, instability, and poorly controlled borders, it's no surprise that counterfeit products are so widespread in Lebanon. Despite strict laws against it, counterfeit is still part of the culture, everywhere to be seen yet barely noticed.
بني ادم عم بقلدوا عم شالدوا عم بقلدوا كل شيء شو ما بدك بقلدوا
بتطلعي بتلاقي زيت الاسم بتشتري.
To substitute for an inefficient consumer protection office, Brand Protection Group was born, a coalition of major corporations working to fight counterfeit. We were asked to create an awareness campaign on counterfeit and promote the call center. Our idea stemmed from our reality, the closest things to you can be fake. In Arabic, the word mqallada means, at the same time, fake, counterfeit, and imitation. We wanted March 15th, the International Anti-Counterfeit Day, to be the climax of our integrated campaign. We started building awareness 1 week before.
Bonjour, Hayate.
Hi,
Hayate. How are you? What did you say to your family today? من مضينا شي 3 ايام عندهم بالجبل اشتقنا لهم ولو حياتي في شي
اقرب الاشياء ممكن تكون مزوره اذا انغشيتوا بمنتج مقلد اتصلوا على 1739 وطالبوا بحقكم
اي صابونه تحممت اليوم
On March 15th, for 48 hours, Lebanon witnessed the biggest orchestrated stunt in the history of the Middle East's traditional and unconventional media. The highest nationally circulated newspaper agreed to fake its front page logo as part of a joint experiment. We asked people to spot the difference and report it. As expected, very few people noticed. So the next day, the experiment's purpose was revealed. You need to look harder. The closest things to you can be fake. In Beirut's biggest shopping mall, dozens of young people in branded t-shirts were released amongst shoppers to imitate their every gesture. Before exposing shoppers to the subtle differences between real and fake products. Marcel Ghanem, the iconic host of the most watched socio-political TV program on the nation's leading station, willingly fell victim to our anti-counterfeit campaign.
مساء الخير من كلام الناس.
The fake host was in fact the agency's managing director, who happened to resemble him.
ولكن قبل هيدا كله
هلأ لازم فعلا نقول مساء الخير مثل ما شفتوا لازم تكونوا اكتشفتوا الفرق بين المزور والأصلي إذا كانت هذه مقدمة مش أصلية إمنا فيها استثنائيا ليلي
For 15 minutes on prime television, counterfeit was discussed with the client. Three famous radio show hosts also got a cut of the action, with lousy imposters filling in for them on air.
Bonjour tout le monde, merci d'être branchés sur Nostalgie.
Vous avez probablement constaté que nous avions une voix différente ce matin.
J'ai pris ma retraite moi
voilà,
aujourd'hui.
Ce n'était pas Layla, c'était quelque chose que nous avons fait spécialement ce matin pour la journée internationale de la lutte contre la contrefaçon.
That morning, the Lebanese social media was shaken by a disturbing reality when 250 influencers, bloggers, and journalists were impersonated on Facebook. We created fake profiles using our victims' real profile pictures and names very similar to their own. When they received friend requests from their imposters, panic struck the social media scene. Within 24 hours, all the impersonated people had asked their friends to report the fake profiles as news of the issue spread. We then sent a personalized message to the targeted individuals, explaining the campaign and offering them an exclusive media kit. This turned our 250 victims into ambassadors who spread our message across media. The synergy of all stunts led to a massive conversation in the country, even becoming the main case study in a social media course at the leading Middle East university. In a country of 4 million, more than 490,000 saw our newspaper stunt. More than 700,000 witnessed our TV and radio stunts. More than 40,000 people online were engaged by our Facebook stunt. 27,000 people saw our mall stunt. In total, our integrated campaign reached more than 3.6 million people, 92% of the population, and received free media coverage worth $375,000. In a month's time, the call center witnessed an 850% increase in the number of callers. Lebanon may not be free of fake products, but with this level of awareness, counterfeit can no longer go unnoticed.